Hello people, in this video let us look at the types of cesarean operations. Basically based on the location where they make the incision, there are types, that's all. Like look at this one, this is a lower segment cesarean section. So lower segment of the uterus will be cut. Okay, so this is the most common one where you're cutting the lower segment of the uterus. Look at the image here. So you can see the lower segment of the uterus is cut. Either a transverse cut or a vertical cut or a J-shaped cut, but all of these are at the lower segment of the uterus. Okay, but there's another type of cesarean called as classical, where you have the incision being done on the upper segment. Like here you can see, this is the incision, right? So basically this is not done anymore, and it is done only when lower segment is not up, they cannot approach it, or there are some adhesions here, right? Only in such conditions they are doing classical. Okay, or the mother is perimortem, she's going to die, or she's dead and suddenly they're removing the baby. Only in such cases they are doing classical. Okay, so did you understand guys that there are two types? So you have the lower segment and the classical. Okay, so in lower segment again you have many types of incision. Yeah, those will be types of incision for you. Now let us look at the theory here, what they are saying about lower segment. This is where you are extracting the baby through an incision made in the lower segment, you are going transperitoneally. There's a transperitoneal approach. This is the only thing that is practiced nowadays. Okay, and whenever somebody says cesarean section, they usually refer to a lower segment cesarean section or LSCS. Okay, and classical, when do you do classical? Basically you're extracting the baby through an incision made in the upper segment. This is not done, it is very limited, and only in some forced circumstances they are saying, like when the lower segment approach is difficult, there is adhesions because of previous abdominal operation, right? Or there is some contracted pelvis, guys, with a pendulous abdomen. So they are saying that there is some kind of anatomy which does not allow them to do a normal LSCS. Okay, so a contracted pelvis or a pendulous abdomen, etc. Then when you are approaching lower segment, it's risky. Why? Because there's a fibroid there, or there's a cervix carcinoma there, right? So there's a fibroid in the lower segment, or there's a carcinoma in the lower segment, or repair of high VVF. What is this? Repair of high VVF? That is vesico-vaginal fistula. That is, there is a fistula, that is some connecting tract between the bladder and the vagina. Okay, so that is when they don't want to do something to the lower segment, or there is a complete anterior placenta previa. So look at this guys, this is placenta previa, this you know, but they are saying if it is an anterior placenta previa, so you're cutting from the anterior side, isn't it? So can you cut through the placenta? No. So if there is an anterior placenta previa, then you cannot do this kind of lower segment cesarean, right? So this is what they are saying, when lower segment approaches, risky, right? So when there is complete anterior placenta previa, then there will be a risk of hemorrhage, so you cannot do a lower segment approach. When won't you approach the lower segment at all? If there's a fibroid, or there's some carcinoma cervix, or there's a vesico-vaginal fistula, or there's a complete anterior placenta previa, so you don't want to approach in this case because of hemorrhage. Perimortem cesarean section. So this is one of the things that they actually use it for, to have a live baby. So the perimortem means what? Around the death, is it? So this is an extreme emergency procedure, and if the woman has suffered cardiac arrest, then the infant will survive if you can get it out within 10 minutes of maternal death. Just remember guys, 10 minutes. Okay, so these are the types of cesarean operations. Actually whenever they are saying cesarean, they mean lower segment cesarean section. Now let us these are the photos that you have looked at. A lot of types of incisions are there. We are not talking about the incisions, we're talking about the types of cesarean. Okay, now look at the merits and demerits of lower segment versus classical. Okay, let's look at this. The technique of lower segment is actually difficult, but why do you do it? Okay, we want that. See, the thing is, focus on the main point here guys. See, here you have the main point. See, the upper segment will undergo contraction and relaxation. Okay, unlike the lower segment which will be quiescent. So the lower segment will not undergo this contractions and relaxation. It is going to be quiescent. So what will happen? This lower one will heal better. You'll have perfect muscle apposition. You'll have minimal wound hematoma. The wound remains quiescent during healing process, right? There is a chance of gutter formation is unlikely, etc. In future also, she can have pregnancies, right? Let's see this one, the classical one. The classical one, what are they saying? Look at the wound here. Imperfect muscle apposition, thick margins, wound hematoma. The wound is in a state of tension because of contraction and relaxation of the upper segment. The knots may slip or the sutures may become loose. Gutter formation on the inner aspect is more. Okay, so this is the main thing. Then, in future, what happens? The scar will not rupture in a LSCS. In an LS, lower segment cesarean section, the scar rupture in future pregnancy is less, okay? But in classical, the scar rupture, more risk of scar rupture, okay? Now look at all the other differences that you have to write in case you're asked in the exam. So it's lower segment is actually difficult, but you're still doing it, right? Let us look at this. Everything is positive. Actually, classical is technically easy. That's why they are doing classical whenever there is an emergency, especially when there is maternal mortality. They are thinking they have to get the baby out, or they really don't think about future pregnancies. Okay, everything else is in favor of lower segment. Look at this. Blood loss is less. The wall is thin. Apposition is perfect. Perfect peritonization is possible. Okay, then hemorrhage and shock is less. Peritonitis is less, adhesions are less, convalescence is better, morbidity, mortality are low. Everything is in favor of lower segment, except one thing that we are seeing here, that is this one. If there is placenta previa, then you cannot, or there is a transverse lie, the baby is lying something like this, transverse lie, is it? If the baby is lying transverse, what will happen? There is a technical difficulty they are seeing. Otherwise, there is lower segment is the most commonly done, right? So, did you understand, guys, the merits and demerits of lower segment operation versus classical? So, in this video, you have looked at the types of cesarean operation. In the next few videos, we will look very much in detail about lower segment cesarean section because this is the most commonly done, right?